Have you ever passed by an empty old mansion and wondered why no one has saved it? Some huge, haunted-looking landmarks have the potential to be transformed into lavish homes, but despite their dilapidated state, many still have huge price tags attached to them. And even if you could afford them, some have dark secrets hidden in their history that might put you off your purchase. With that, let's take a look at some of the world's most amazing abandoned mansions. Castello Diga. We know that every man's home is his castle, but how would you like to live in an actual castle? Well, if you have a cool $1.2 million squirreled away and don't mind moving to the gorgeous region of Ragusa, Sicily, that dream could become a reality. The abandoned Castello Diga has an ample floor space of 21,500 square feet throughout its many buildings, including an old church, a country house, and a variety of other outhouses. Like any true castle, it comes with a turreted wall, which would be perfect for surveying the 17 acres of land you'd also own. But as you can see, the inside is a little run down, so parts of this not-so-fairy tale castle would require a lot of love and money to make it habitable. Experts in the castle renovation business say restoring places like this can cost around 460 euros per square foot. That's about $550. So, although Castello Diga may look like a total bargain from the front, it could cost up to $11.8 million to renovate. Turns out this tiny kingdom has a royal price tag attached. Want to know what'll make you feel like royalty and won't cost you a penny? Hitting those like and subscribe buttons. You'll be the first to know when my new videos are released, which is the YouTube version of receiving the royal treatment. Now, my liege, let us continue to peruse the world's most remarkable abandoned mansions. Elda Castle. Did you think that all castles were in Europe? Think again. This abandoned fairy tale looking property sits in the secluded reaches of Westchester County, New York, and like its mysterious appearance suggests, it has a few secrets hidden within its walls. It was built all the way back in 1927 by David Abercrombie, the co-owner of clothing brand Abercrombie & Fitch. Elda Castle, which sits on a 49.5-acre estate, incorporated a huge open patio, spiraling cast-iron staircases, 25 rooms, and an amazing view of the Hudson River. After the house was exchanged through several different owners over the years, it went through many failed renovation attempts. Constant setback from fires and vandalism meant no renovator could see the project through, and it sat in this abandoned state on the market in 2017 at $3.7 million. It was bought quickly, but is now back on the market yet again for just $3.2 million. This seems like one very expensive and so far unsuccessful renovation adventure. Perhaps it's even haunted? It wouldn't be surprising, seeing as two of Abercrombie's four children died in tragic accidents while they lived here. It seems to me that this crumbling castle would be prime real estate, if you're a ghost. Nakhon Pathom. The province of Nakhon Pathom on the outskirts of Bangkok, Thailand, is full of expensive reminders of Asia's 1997 financial collapse. In the year where the most affected Asian economy saw a $100 billion drop in capital, these gigantic mansions for Thailand's wealthy elite were being constructed. As the money dried up, the quiet suburb was abandoned, leaving five of these mostly built mansions empty. With no one able to afford them, they remained unoccupied until the 2000s, when two families of caretakers moved in to look after the properties. But it's a lot of work for just a few hands. As you can see, the neglected pools have turned green with sludge and algae, and the facades are covered in over 20 years of grime. Had they been kept in good shape, they could have reached prices like this magnificent mansion in the same area. Currently, it's on the market for 16.5 million Thai baht, which comes to just over $530,000. However, two decades of deterioration and outdated styles are likely to count against any proposed price tags for its rundown counterparts. What would you be willing to pay for a slice of this high Thai life? Let me know in the comments. Koom Park. The Coombe Park Mansion in Whitchurch on Thames, England, sits on an immense 125 acres of land. That's the same size as 2,000 tennis courts. But keep hold of your balls until you hear the price attached to all that space, because it's a big one. Built in 1865 and refurbished in the 1980s, its owners went bankrupt and the mansion was seized by the High Courts. And as you can see, the interior is a time capsule of 80s style. The 6 bedrooms still have floral drapes and headboards, the 5 bathrooms have lavishly gold-colored accessories, and the large, curved staircases lead to gigantic rooms of all styles. But the piece de resistance of this place has to be the derelict indoor pool. It has painted murals and mosaic tiles, and is even big enough to skate around when it's empty. Considering it's been abandoned for the best part of 30 years, it's in remarkably good condition, although other elements like its boathouse and outdoor swimming pool haven't fared as well. I wouldn't risk a dip in there if I were you. So, can you guess how much it went for in the market in 2015? It ended up being listed at £10 million. At the time, that was a wallet-busting $15.2 million. Just like that 80s style, that price is certainly eccentric. Flass House. In July 2014, the Grade 2 listed Flass House in Cumbria, England was worth $1.9 million. Now keep that price in your mind, because it's going to be blown when you learn what happened to it. The 23,000 square foot, 52-room retreat once boasted a beautifully furnished library, complete with a hidden room, incredible views, and a gorgeously detailed foyer. It was the home of singer-songwriter Christine Holmes and her husband Paul Davis. But following a nasty divorce, Davis took control of Flass House. Spiraling maintenance costs saw him fall into the pocket of a drug-dealing gang in 2011. Along with 5 cohorts, he turned his white-walled mansion into a, wacky-tobacky factory, worth $6.8 million today. Mold and damp ruined the rooms where the devil's cabbage had been grown. The kitchen was trashed beyond use, and the stunning interiors were vandalized beyond recognition. After Paul and company were arrested, the house was put up for auction in 2019. But the state it had been left in dragged its final selling price down to a measly $596,000. That's less than a third of its value from 5 years before. If you ever needed an excuse not to get involved with a Grim Reaper, I'd say this is it. Mike Tyson's Lost Mansion. Mike Tyson has done all right for himself recently. The ear-biting boxing legend is back in the ring. His acting career took off, and he's thought to have a net worth of around $3 million. But it's a life far removed from the one he had. Back in the 1980s, when he was earning upwards of $10 million per match, he was the owner of this 19,500-square-foot mansion, which sits on 58 acres of land in Ohio. And he didn't skim on the trimmings. His huge indoor pool has a Sunday bar at the side, garish zebra print carpet graced the halls and stairs, and his bathroom was the gaudiest green and gold combination. And it wouldn't be a real mansion without tiger cages, which he used to keep his 3 Bengal tigers. Eat your heart out, Joe Exotic. But in 1992, it all came crashing down when he was jailed for sexual assault, and then again in 1999. The elaborate mansion was purchased for an incredible $1.3 million, but no one ever moved in. A user called MoneyPenny2020 tried to sell the mansion on eBay for $3.5 million, but it went into foreclosure. Then, in 2020, after laying abandoned for 10 years, it has finally been converted into a church. That grungy green pool was replaced with a place of prayer, and that zebra carpet was ripped up and relaid with a holy blue. I wish they'd kept the tiger cages, though. They'd definitely have made Mass a little more interesting. High Point Mansion. Toronto's Bridal Path is a row of lavish mansions that have been inhabited by famous faces like Robert Herjavec, Drake, and even Prince. However, one mansion on High Point Road stands out among the rest, because it's both unfinished and completely empty. In 2020, this mansion hit the market at close to 18 million Canadian. That's $13.4 million if you don't know your loonies from your toonies. It's an insanely high price considering it isn't finished. But when you look inside, you can see why. It boasts a gigantic foyer and a grand double stairway that will greet you with serious style. The house also boasts 15 bathrooms, 9 bedrooms, and parking space for 31 cars, all spread out over 16,000 square feet. As impressive as it looks, elements like its cold cellar are still awaiting construction, and most of the kitchens haven't been completed either. It does leave you with one burning question. Why was it never finished? Well, one theory from Blog2 suggests that it has been left this way so that a new owner can finish it to their own dream specifications. A different theory from urban explorer Freaktography speculates that there was a controversial event in 2020 which affected several houses on the row, meaning construction had to be put on hold. Do any of you internet super sleuths have any insider info or any other theories about why this High Point mansion has been left high and dry? Let me know in the comments below. The Scottsdale Home. Let's cast our minds back to the year 2012, where nobody knew what WhatsApp was and text messages were king. At that time, tech entrepreneur Jason Hope was in the middle of building this crazy compound estate in Scottsdale, Arizona. He was planning to make it 100,000 square feet of paradise. With more than 9 buildings stretching out over 14 acres, a man-made river, multiple interior garages, and even an indoor bowling alley, with some pretty questionable art to boot. And did I mention all of it was going to be connected by tunnels? Was he planning on building a home or the crazy lair of a Bond villain? We'll never find out, I'm afraid, because Jason's dreams came skidding to a halt when his company, Jawa, became embroiled in a scandal. They'd swindled thousands of customers out of their money. And even though the lawsuits that besieged Jason were settled in 2012, work on his massive mansion never resumed. Instead, the entire unfinished lot was sold for just $5 million. And since then, it doesn't look like anyone has been brave or stupid enough to restart the project. Google Maps shows you that to this day, the compound looks abandoned. I mean, it doesn't even have a roof. But here's the kicker. Property selling sites like Redfin now have the entire compound listed at an estimated $1.46 million. That's less than half of what the unfinished compound was sold for. Unless someone buys it soon, it looks like this evil lair is destined for evil doom. American Versailles. At 90,000 square feet, the Versailles Mansion in Windermere, Florida is approximately 9 times as large as most of its neighboring houses. But the mega mansion has taken over 17 years to construct and lay abandoned for a good chunk of that time. Its millionaire owners, Jackie Siegel and her timeshare mogul husband, David Siegel, were hit hard by the financial crash of 2008. Cutting costs wherever they could, construction was halted on their dream home project. For over 4 years, the would-be dream house, set to feature 30 bathrooms, 14 bedrooms, and 9 kitchens, sat completely empty. While it hardly comes close to hitting the real Versailles 2,300 rooms and almost 680,000 square feet, can Marie Antoinette say she had an indoor roller rink, a 30-car garage, or a 30-foot stained glass dome worth $500,000? I think not. But when it came to the credit crunch in 2010, the house had to be put up for sale. Even with just 2/3 of the construction complete, it hit the market at an eye-watering $75 million, but with no takers, was slashed down to $65 million. Gee, what a bargain. Following some better financial fortune, construction on the house resumed in 2019, and the Siegels are expected to have appraised it at over $100 million once it's completed. I think this proves that money really can buy you just about anything, except perhaps good taste. Kinmel Hall. If you thought the $100 million American Versailles was too gaudy, then why not take a look at the Welsh Versailles for just a fraction of the price? Bought for just under $1.9 million in 2011, this 122-room Victorian building was constructed all the way back in 1876. With at least 50 guest bedrooms and 60 servants' quarters, every single guest in this mansion could be waited on hand and foot. Can you imagine what kind of amazing parties were held in these huge ballrooms? Or what esteemed guests must have made their way down these huge stairs? Over the years, it's been used as a boys' school, a health spa, and even a military hospital. But after it was bought in 2011 for $2.6 million less than its original asking price, this discount Downton Abbey remained derelict. Then, in 2020, the owning company was accused of making unauthorized work on the Grade 1 listed building, resulting in an injunction on the site. With the mansion continuing to lose value the longer it sits unused, it could come back up on the market any day now. If not, it could be curtains for this historic landmark, which would be a lot of work with that many windows. Mobutu's Bamboo Palace. We've covered the American and Welsh versions of Versailles, now it's time to say hello to the African Versailles. This ruined jungle paradise of Gabatolite was once home to the President Mobutu, the former ruler of the Democratic Republic of Congo. He lavished approximately $130 million on his presidential bamboo palace. And, as you can imagine, that kind of money went pretty far back during the time of his rule. The palace included 20,000 tons of marble, high-carat gold-plated windows, a king-sized swimming pool, and even a game park that he filled with Indian tigers. It's pretty hard to picture these ruins boasting all that finery now, though. That's because when his 32-year dictatorship was toppled in 1997 and he was forced to flee, the looting that followed left the palace stripped bare of just about everything. Only things that were too heavy to retrieve, like these gigantic crystal chandeliers, went mostly untouched. So, the compound was transformed from a lavish mansion costing around $15 million to run every single month to ransacked ruins that even had the silk covering stripped from its walls. It's almost as if they were stripping the very memory of the clearly corrupt president from their history. Howie House. The overgrown, haunted-looking foundations of Howie House once looked more like a nightmare than dream real estate. Completed in 1927, the 20-room, 7,200-square-foot mansion cost $250,000 to build. In today's money, that's about $3.7 million. But over the years, it began to really show its age. Poor upkeep meant the fastest-growing gardens took over the grounds and smothered the pond with grim-looking algae. Show-stopping features like these giant fireplaces and antique wooden doors weren't cleaned or maintained properly, leaving them dirty and worn. Due to bad investments made in 2005, its then-owner, Marvel Zona, lost the mansion and it was foreclosed. Her lawyers indicated the mansion was only worth $2 million at that point, with a staggering $1.5 million required for repairs and restorations, including installing air conditioning. At that price, no one was in a hurry to step forward to take it, and it sat empty and abandoned for over 12 years. Eventually, following some serious legal issues, it was listed at a paltry $480,000. That's just 13% of what it initially cost to build. Then, in 2017, it was snapped up and renovated through a $600,000 investment. It's now been restored to most of its former glory, turning this haunted house into a magical-looking mansion. The Bishop's Avenue. The Bishop's Avenue in North London, England, also known as Billionaire's Row, is lined with 66 very impressive-looking mansions that have a combined worth of approximately $620 million. But while some are meticulously taken care of, others are derelict husks, like this one, simply called The Towers. It was one of 10 homes on the row built by the Saudi royal family in 1989 to the tune of $40 million. And that was less than half the original asking price at the time. If it were in better condition, taking inflation into account, there's a chance it could have been worth about $143 million today. But in the 30 years they've owned it, it's rarely been visited. Now it sits derelict, with the only residents being the occasional brave photographer. Moss covers the walls and floors at points where the building has crumbled away, exposing the house to the elements. The once grand foyer is in an advanced state of rot, and the empty swimming pool at its base is littered with skeletons of pigeons, rats, and mice. But it's not the only one. The Georgians, which sits only a few doors down from the towers, is also owned by the Saudi royal family. But just like towers, it too sits in a totally derelict condition. The once sleek walls have been left cracked and crumbling, ceilings and rafters have rotted away, and the bathroom looks like someone really went to town on the plumbing. By the looks of things, it'd take more than a bit of TLC to turn these rotten ruins into a dream home. But even in this state, it's still worth almost $40 million. It might seem like a total waste of potential, but there are silver linings in these fragile foundations. According to UK legislations, renovation costs of houses that have been left empty for the last 2 years, like the Georgians and the towers, are eligible for a reduction in value-added tax. It's reduced to just 5% from the 20% it would normally cost. And if they're beyond repair, demolishing and constructing a new home on their grounds might not be subject to tax at all. That's one way to make the entire process much less taxing. Japanese billionaire mansion. Hidden in the bushes on the outskirts of Tokyo lies this mega mansion, formerly inhabited by the Japanese billionaire and avid art collector Genshiro Kawamoto. He was arrested in 2018 for tax evasion, and since then his massive mansion has sat empty, even though it's filled to the brim with a host of wondrous treasures. Beautiful statues are littered throughout the entire property, and I mean littered. Everywhere you look, another statue can be seen guarding the house. Seemingly priceless art hangs on the walls, and the immaculately carved furniture sits untouched in the middle of the rooms. And that's not all. Kawamoto's estate encompasses a second mansion, which holds even more precious-looking statues in its space. Do you think Genshiro really was an art collector, or was he secretly married to Medusa? The estate isn't currently up for sale, but similar-looking properties in the same area are listed at $8.5 million, and that's without the added value of a secret treasure trove hidden deep within them. The Peter Grant Mansion. Sometimes, the bigger a place is built, the harder it falls into disrepair. And that's never been truer than for Canada's famous Peter Grant Mansion. At a staggering 65,000 square feet, this lofty lakeside residence on the Temiskaming shoreline is Canada's largest mansion. But despite having 43 acres of land, an indoor pool, and 30-foot fireplaces, it's never been a habitable home. Urban explorer Freaktography managed to creep inside and get a look around earlier in 2020. As you can see from the bare floors, sketchy-looking scaffolding, and a total lack of decor, it was never finished. In 2009, it was well on its way to being built when its owner and forestry mogul Peter Grant hit dire financial straits. His company filed for bankruptcy, and the shell of the house was placed on the market in 2010 for $25 million Canadian. Nowadays, that's just over $22 million. It was bought by a Toronto-based company. However, all they've done since then is put up a few security cameras and private property signs. Meanwhile, the house itself has been left untouched. So, what would this be worth now? Well, I did a bit of digging and found out lakeside land in Temiskaming Shores can go for around $109,000 per acre. That means that at 43 acres, the mansion's land alone could be worth about $4.6 million. But the disintegrating structure probably isn't worth $17.5 million anymore, the figure you'd land on if you deducted the land value from the property's 2010 asking price. And it's possible the disrepair might have knocked a few million off its original price. What do you reckon this forsaken fixer-upper is worth these days? Let me know in the comments. Sanmazzano Castle. You're going to be so dazzled by this next place that you'll probably struggle to believe it was ever abandoned in the first place. But believe it or not, the Sanmazzano Castle once sat gathering dust for 3 decades on the Tucson Hills of Florence, Italy. Built some 400 years ago on 65 stunning acres of exotic parkland, this eclectic castle has almost 60,000 square feet of livable space, which is about the same size as an American football field. But I wouldn't go throwing a pigskin about these intricately decorated rooms if I were you, because they took around 36 years to renovate back in the 1880s. From the peacock room with its fantail designs and the stalactite room with its swanky ceiling to the white room, which looks like it's been plucked straight out of the Taj Mahal. In fact, there are 365 rooms, each with its own exotic twist, in this magnificent mansion. That's one for every day of the year. It was briefly turned into a hotel back in the 1970s, but the cost of its maintenance far exceeded the price its guests could pay, and it closed in the 1990s. However, it hit the market in 2018, can you guess how much for? Almost $19 million. Let's hope the person who bought it has enough money left over to keep this castle in its wonderful, colorful condition. Which of these mansions would you most like to own if you could? Let me know in the comments below. And thanks for watching.